Hello world, my name is Anisha Malde and I'm a developer evangelist here at Amazon. And today I'm going to be covering the transition to the new Appstore SDK for in-app purchases. The Appstore SDK provides functionality for handling digital rights management, DRM, and in-app purchasing, IAP, within your Java Android apps. IAP protects your in-app purchases, whereas DRM protects your app from unauthorized distribution. The new Appstore SDK will replace the previous SDK IAP v2. It differs from the old SDK in a few ways. Firstly, Amazon will no longer enforce DRM for your app by adding a wrapper to your APK. Previously, when you uploaded Android APKs into the Amazon App Store, you had the option to select Yes or No for Apply Amazon DRM on the APK Files tab. With the new Appstore SDK, Amazon no longer adds this wrapper around your APK after you submit it. Instead, if you need DRM for your Android app, you need to take some extra steps to incorporate some license checking functions in your app through the DRM API. Secondly, the IAP API is no longer available as a separate JAR file. Previously, when you wanted in-app purchasing functionality, you downloaded a standalone IAP JAR and incorporated it into your app. Now, it is bundled with the Appstore SDK JAR file. This switchover to the new Appstore SDK does not need to be immediate, and it depends on whether you're a new or existing developer. For new Appstore developers, you must use Appstore SDK if you need DRM or IAP in new apps. As an existing developer, the free Amazon Managed DRM will no longer be available if you update your app to use the Appstore SDK. As mentioned, to incorporate DRM, you will need to use the DRM API available in the new SDK. If you don't update to Appstore SDK, your app's in-app purchasing and DRM functionality will remain the same. However, the Amazon Managed DRM will be deprecated in the future. So let's get into the technicalities of how to update your app to the Amazon SDK for in-app purchasing. Before we jump in, it's important to note that the Appstore SDK requires devices to have at least Android API level 14 or higher. The first step is to head to the SDK download page and download the new Appstore SDK for Android. The download includes the IAP JAR file, API documentation, and examples, and the link can be found in the description below. The second step is to remove the in-app purchasing JAR from your app and any references to it. Then, delete the old SDK file from the libs folder within your app. The third step is to configure the Appstore SDK with your public key. If you're an existing developer, create a new version of your app. If you're a new developer, head to the developer portal and with your developer account, create a new app and fill in the required fields as shown on screen. Click Save, and once it's created a new version of your app, head over to the APK Files tab. Here, you will see a link for your public key in the upper right area. Click this link and a public key dialog box will appear. Click the Appstore Authentication Key PEM link to download a PEM file. This file contains your public key. In App, and then Source, and then Main, create an Assets folder and copy in the Appstore Authentication Key file. This public key, which is unique per app, establishes a secure communication channel between the Amazon App Store and your app. The final step is to add the SDK to your app. To ensure your app will always use the latest version of the SDK, you can integrate the Amazon App Store SDK using Maven. The example shows you how to get the latest Amazon SDK version. You can also define specific versions and/or wildcards. Using wildcards is not a suitable option for a live project because of unforeseen stability issues. However, using wildcards in your version declaration can be useful while debugging or testing your project against the latest version of the Amazon Appstore SDK. Replace any segment of the version number with a plus to use the latest iteration. Make sure your project's top-level build Gradle has a Maven Central repository defined or added in otherwise. Alternatively, you can add the SDK JAR directly into your project. To do this, open your app's build Gradle file and add a dependency to the Amazon App Store SDK JAR, depending on the version you want to use. For example, if the jar was version 3.0.2, the code would look like this. If you have multiple dependencies, instead of referring to a specific jar, you can reference all jars more generically like this. Then, copy in the jar file from the downloaded SDK into the libs folder within your app. And that's it! Your app will be upgraded to the new SDK, so you can submit a new version of your app. When you submit your app, you can choose to offer your app DRM-free, manage your own DRM, or you can use the AppStore DRM API. However, if you transition to the new AppStore SDK, you will no longer be able to use the Amazon Managed DRM. So let's see how you can transition to the new DRM API. Assuming you have already integrated the AppStore SDK, you need to add logic in your app to check for licenses. You can do this by following the instructions on the link shown on screen or find the link in the description below. This link shows you how to enforce DRM in your app. Once you've done this, build a new version of your APK, upload it into the developer console, and submit it. If you upload an APK that uses an older IAP SDK or no SDK at all, then you will see the following warning. To discover more, head over to developer.amazon.com. For more information on transitioning to the AppStore SDK or enforcing DRM, check out the links on screen or find them in the description below. Thank you for your time. I hope this video was useful in understanding how to use the AppStore SDK. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like and subscribe.